Imagine it's 11:30 at night and you've got a remote server that's locked up. You really just need to go hit the power button, but it's across town or it's across the country. You've either got to make that drive out to the location or you got to find someone to hit the button for you. That's where KVM over IP comes in. Now, KVM over IP is nothing new. There are plenty of options out there ranging from DIY solutions up to enterprise IPMI cards. But GL.iNet, the brand behind those top-tier travel routers that we all know and love, has created a new lineup of KVM devices that suits almost every use case. And they've got a couple of new ones that you're gonna wanna take a look at. In this video, we're gonna talk about two new GL.iNet KVMs, the Comet PoE and the Comet Pro. Both of these devices can give you access and control over your remote systems, but it's polished into a dead simple and affordable solution with some really neat features included. Okay, let's dive in and take a look. I want to thank GL.iNet for sponsoring this video. They've been a brand that I have loved since way before they were a sponsor of this channel, and I use their products in my own deployments. I take the Slate 7 router anywhere that I travel, and I've got the multifunctional Spitz AX gateway in my RV. But I've only recently had a need for KVM over IP. Earlier this year, I opened up a dedicated studio office, and I've often found myself needing to connect to servers at one office or the other, so these KVMs couldn't have come at a better time. Let's take a look at the hardware. Starting with the Comet PoE, we've got this nice small form factor with ports on the back for USB 2, that's for some of the optional accessories like the fingerbot that I'm gonna discuss later in this video. Then we've got a full-size HDMI port, which means no adapters or hunting around for some sort of compatible cable. We've got USB-C for keyboard and mouse, simple and universal. And yes, we've got PoE, which means one cable for power and network to keep your network rack clean. But you can still power it with USB-C on the side if you want. On the inside of the Comet PoE, we've also got a 32 gig eMMC drive for sharing files with the connected host computer. Next, we have the Comet Pro. This is an excellent choice for connecting to a server or to your home PC because it has 4K HDMI video pass-through. I can connect to my studio PC from anywhere, but since the Comet Pro lives in line with my main workstation, it's invisible when I'm local, but it's indispensable when I'm remote. This is a nice little device for when you want to take a vacation, but work remotely through KVM over IP connected to your home computer. As far as your boss is concerned, you're at home. Besides the dual HDMI pass-through, we've got a USB 2 accessory port, we've got two USB Type-C ports, one of those is for KVM connectivity and the other one is for power, and then we also have an RJ45 Ethernet port, but this is optional since the Comet Pro has built-in Wi-Fi 6. It does not have to be hardwired into the network. The Comet Pro also comes with the 32 gigs of eMMC storage, and it has this beautiful touchscreen display. The touchscreen lets you manage a bunch of different features. You've got wireless settings, you can set up a pin code, it controls the brightness, and it even functions as a desk clock. So at a glance, I can see status, but with a swipe, I can reboot the KVM or lock it down. All right, we've seen the ports, we've seen the hardware, but what really matters most is how it works when you're logged in, because the real power of KVM over IP isn't just how they connect, it's in what you can actually do when you're inside the admin GUI. Like any good tech, I'm gonna start with security. You can, of course, password protect the admin GUI, but they've also included two-factor authentication that works in conjunction with Google Authenticator, Authy, or any other TOTP-capable software. Under settings, you can tweak the display, you can tweak the keyboard and mouse behavior, and they've even added dark mode for all of you dark mode freaks out there. At the bottom, we have our network settings, and if you have the Comet Pro, you'll also see Wi-Fi settings. Under Toolbox, we've got a clipboard for pasting text into the remote host, or some handy keyboard shortcuts like Control-Alt-Delete. And then there are the accessories, including my favorite, the fingerbot. And yes, it literally presses the power button for you. A small USB dongle plugs into the KVM and wirelessly controls a little box with a robot finger. But besides having a funny name, it's actually surprisingly useful. On my Minis Forum AI X1 Pro running Ubuntu, I remapped the power button to suspend. Now, a quick light press from the fingerbot puts the server to sleep, and another press wakes it up. If the system hardlocks, I can tell the fingerbot to hold the power button for 8 seconds, forcing a hard shutdown, and then I can follow it up with a short press to bring it back online. When it's booting up, I can even pop into the BIOS if I need to. Another accessory is the ATX board, which sits inside your PC and functions as a pass-through for those annoying little 9-pin headers that plug into the motherboard. This gives you another option for direct control over the power without using the fingerbot. Back in the GUI, we've got virtual media. Both the Comet Pro and PoE include 32 gigs of onboard storage. You can upload files to the KVM and then mount that storage as a drive on the host machine, just as if you had plugged in a USB thumb drive. Now at Crosstalk, we'll preload a Comet with tools before sending it out to a client site, so everything that we need is already there when we connect, which saves us a lot of time and hassle. Then there's the App Center, and my favorite feature of these KVMs, direct Tailscale integration. You click Bind Device, log in with your Tailscale credentials, and now the Comet KVM is part of your Tailnet. It can even function as an exit node for your network. So this means I can use Tailscale to reach my KVMs at both of my offices instantly from anywhere. And if you're not using Tailscale, GL.iNet also provides their own free cloud service at glkvm.com, which gives you a central cloud portal for connecting to all of your connected KVMs. So what's this gonna cost? The original Comet is $90. The PoE model is $109, and the Comet Pro has $159 MSRP. But right now, you can still get it for $129 on Kickstarter. It's gonna start shipping in December. If you'd like to check out GL.iNet's full lineup of KVMs, I've got a link with a discount down in the description. So yeah, I've really been enjoying these KVMs. The feature set is solid and they work exactly as advertised. And with three different models to choose from, you've got options for any use case or budget. Thanks again to GL.iNet for sponsoring this video. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my full overview of the Slate 7 travel router, and the bottom video is a detailed overview of my own Wi-Fi setup for my RV.